3 weeks, the parties will have been separated for 2 years. This action has been pending for approximately 22 months. The defendant is now on her fourth attorney. The combined legal fees in this case are now over $25,000. These are some of the factors why we've brought this action at this time. The previous attorney has filed an attorney's lien against the marital property of over $7,000.
A court system open to members of the public is a cornerstone of a free society. Through it, members of the public can bring their disputes before the courts for binding resolution.
Hardship, and clearly there is incentive. Again,
however, litigation is not simple. It is highly formalized, it is time-consuming, and it can be quite expensive. Moreover, litigation is built around a win-lose model. One side wins, the other side loses.
I'm going to object at this point. That's not what the record...
All these factors taken together can leave parties to litigation dissatisfied, regardless of the outcome. While litigation is the traditional method for resolving disputes, there are alternatives. Mediation and arbitration are two. In many situations, they've proven to be able to provide more effective remedies and remedies that are more satisfactory to the parties. They don't focus so much on declaring winners and losers as they focus on solving problems. And particularly in the situation where the parties to a dispute will have to deal with each other afterwards, they've often been superior to litigation. Our purpose today is to briefly familiarize you with these alternative dispute or ADR options. Knowledge of these options should assist you in making better decisions about how to resolve your current dispute.
Litigation is costly, it's adversarial, it's incredibly time-consuming, it's exacting, plus the emotional side of receiving these things in the mail and the accusations and the formality and the feeling of frustration because you can't just say, come on, you guys, let's be reasonable.
Most litigation will go on for months and sometimes for years.
Very seldom is there ever a distinct two winners. Usually it's one loser, one winner. Sometimes no winners.
When you go to court, you go to court to compete to win a lawsuit. Mediation is a process where parties come together to try to find a mutually satisfactory solution to the problem.
It's less formal, less intimidating.
Mediation can be held in confidentiality.
The most appealing thing about mediation is the simplicity of it and the economics.
I feel like both parties come out as winners.
In a mediation, the two disputants choose a mediator or a neutral third party who's skilled at facilitation, at communication, and at understanding the issues. They then convene a meeting, and the mediator basically helps them identify the issues, come up with solutions, and come to an agreement.
I serve as a mediator today, and what that means is I serve as a neutral to help you as you negotiate to try to resolve this matter. I don't have the authority of a judge or an arbitrator to impose a result or to say who's right or wrong. My role
What a mediator provides is safety with some structure. So people have confidence that the discussion is not going to get out of control.
Radiates up from my neck. I'm in pain. And
it helps people to look at one another and look at your adversary, if you will, or the person that you have a concern with, and look at them and really talk to them about your concerns.
I'd just like to offer my apologies to Fran for the fact that the accident happened, but I don't think it was my fault entirely.
And then after that, the mediator moves between each side in a separate room and consults with each of them.
What I'd like to do now would be to go through a risk analysis with you. Okay, Rich and Fran, what I'd like to do now would be to go through your risk analysis of the case.
The parties have to be intimately involved in the process.
Mediation hands back the control over the timing, the pace. How fast is the process going to go?
And when there's a final resolution, the parties are the ones that came up with that resolution.
Thank you. Thanks, Rich, very much.
In mediation, there's a tremendous amount of creativity that's allowed because you're not constrained by what the court can order. You actually can come up with all kinds of solutions that may not be possible if you do that in a traditional setting.
Even in the construction industry, we have numerous occasions for conflict. They arise on the job, they arise between subcontractors and contractors, between owners and contractors, between the various elements of a construction project, and they're often very complex and difficult.
Okay, great.
In this particular instance, I had heard about mediation, and it seemed appropriate to attempt to resolve a very complex issue. Sitting in the same room, they're allowed to discuss their issues. I'm allowed to discuss mine. The third party's allowed to discuss theirs. Pretty much no holds barred. Everything is laid out on the table from one side to the next with the mediator, and I would say in this instance, very skillfully directing traffic, stating the facts and getting them very clear so that everybody agrees. That was the thing that I found most impressive, was the ability of the mediator to state and establish what the problems were and then attempt to state each person's position and come to a resolution of it. In our instance, it appeared to be a misunderstanding, and it became so clear that both parties, sort of a light went on. And so it was resolved without acrimony and without the usual expenditure of legal fees. All parties to this day were still involved with each other on quite a good basis. And that is probably the most fantastic result you could hope for.
So it's more creative, it's more timely, it's less expensive, and it's also more healing.
It just helped us clear away all the anger and the hostility to truly see what was important in this. And in the divorce, the children are what's important.
They sat down and really talked like civilized people. They would talk and express their feelings and say what they meant, and they got it done a lot better than if they had just gone out and yelled at each other.
Mediation allowed us to resolve it amicably, and we preserved a lot of, I think, what we wanted to preserve, even though we were getting a divorce.
The end of a marriage is just such a ripping apart that, you know, if you can prevent some of that pain, and if mediation is a way to do it, then you should try it.
Mediation is a process where the parties work together to try to resolve the dispute through negotiation. Arbitration is an adversarial evidentiary process where the parties submit the dispute to an expert neutral, the arbitrator, for a decision.
It is my understanding, based on what I've read in the arbitration agreement, that the only witnesses that will be called today are the parties themselves. And it is also my understanding that you have outlined...
Oftentimes, the parties are uncertain about what they believe to be the proper outcome of the case. I mean, certainly both sides have their own perspective. But there are issues that are so complex, or there's some law which is so uncertain, that the parties just need somebody to take a much more assertive hand than a mediator very often will do.
However, considering that this is an arbitration hearing as opposed to an actual trial, I'm going to allow the witness to testify.
I think it gives us a chance to gather up the information early on to present it to a person that we believe to be an informed and capable neutral, and it will give us a strong dose of reality.
In the case of non-binding arbitration, the parties are free to accept the decision and reduce it to an agreement, or reject the decision and go into traditional litigation.
I will be rendering a decision in this matter probably within the next week. It will be written and you'll receive it in the mail. Thank you so much.
Thank
you. I don't think people should think that ADR solves every problem. There are some cases that simply need to be litigated. But all of the dispute resolution processes are designed to help the parties themselves. And now we're given an opportunity to really give it a chance, and I think we ought to make every effort to exploit it and use it wherever possible.
Arbitration or mediation lend themselves to any and all kinds of disputes. You aren't limited in that process, so that should be pointed out to the clients. If it's a construction-type case, a collection case.
Business conflicts, employer-employee conflicts,
or a personal injury dispute, or a contract dispute.
Across gender, across culture, across economic lines.
From the smallest neighborhood or family disputes into the largest kinds of issues involving nations.
It's important to consider all the options and choose which of those is most suited to what you need.
I was thrilled with it.
It was great.
I'd recommend it highly.
I think we should.
Taken together, mediation, arbitration, and traditional litigation provide a full spectrum of mechanisms from which parties may choose. Consider your options. Decide which is best for you, taking into account time, money, and the prospect of a continuing relationship with the other party once the dispute is over. The Utah judiciary is pleased to be able to offer you this range of options in the hope that it will assist you in fashioning a more effective and more satisfactory resolution to your current dispute.